Good afternoon, and welcome to the 2020 Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition Final Round. My name is Joseph Rackers, Artistic Director of the Southeastern Piano Festival.
And I'm Marina Lomazov, Core Artistic Director of the Southeastern Piano Festival, and we welcome you.
This final round is the culmination of a multi-round process that started with a screening of all of the applicants to the Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition. After an initial reduction in candidates to 20, there was a second round in which a second panel of judges chose these five finalists from the group of 20. I know that we're all excited about these performances, but before we begin, I'd like to introduce our competition jury. The jury chair is Dr. Douglas Humphreys, chair of the piano department at the Eastman School of Music and artistic director of the Gina Backhauer International Piano Foundation. Next, I'd like to introduce Morihiko Nakahara, the music director of the South Carolina Philharmonic, resident conductor of the Spokane Symphony Orchestra, and professor of conducting at the University of Massachusetts Amherst. Welcome, Morihiko. And finally, the distinguished Dr. Marina Lomazov, co-founder and artistic director of the Southeastern Piano Festival.
Why, thank you, Joe. We are thankful to so many people and individuals and organizations for making this possible. We're so thrilled that we could conduct this event live. Even though there is no audience in the hall, we know that all of you are watching. The performers will get a chance to play on magnificent piano in a beautiful hall. And actually, two of the judges are here. Of course, all the precautions are being observed in coordination with CD guidelines. We have so many people to thank to make this that we're able to make this possible, and we will be doing so in the intermission around 4 o'clock.
I'd also like to thank our wonderful technical engineer, Jeff Francis, who's helping to make the live stream possible, and our wonderful second pianist, Inara Zadmana, who's accompanying all of these finalists and has been with the festival for many years. And now I would like to welcome to the stage contestant number one, Karina Tseng, who's playing Prokofiev's C minor piano sonata and Chopin E minor concerto. Thank you.
I can say two. I'd say confidence and self-expression, and just being able to define yourself as a unique individual artist because there's so many players out there.
Contestant number two is Caleb Borick. He'll be playing the Rachmaninoff C minor piano concerto and Prokofiev piano sonata number 7.
For me, music is a method of expression. I can say certain things through my playing that I might not be able to express otherwise.
Thank you.
Contestant number three is Katie Liu, and she'll be playing Mozart's Piano Sonata in B-flat, K333, and the Chopin E minor Piano Concerto.
Like, I'm a musician because I want to share the amazing music that I play with as many people as I can. And also, playing classical music gives me a lot of joy.
We've just completed the first portion of the 2020 Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition. We've heard three contestants perform their final program so far. And at about 4:40, we'll hear contestant number four, and about 5 o'clock, we'll hear contestant number five. The Southeastern Piano Festival would like to take this opportunity to thank a number of organizations and individuals that make the festival possible year after year. I'd like to start by acknowledging Rice Music House, the official Steinway dealer of South Carolina. Rice Music House has been providing pianos to the Southeastern Piano Festival, including one of the two Steinway Ds here today, for the duration of the competition over the past 18 years. We are very grateful to Rice Music House and extremely grateful to Steinway & Sons for their support. Thank you. We'd like to thank the South Carolina Symphony League for hosting the Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition in collaboration with the Southeastern Piano Festival. The partnership with the Symphony League and the South Carolina Philharmonic provides a unique opportunity for these young artists to perform with a full concerto with the symphony orchestra. It has been a wonderful partnership, and we're very grateful. Rhonda Hunsinger, the Symphony League of the South Carolina Philharmonic, and Morihiko Nakahara, the music director. I'd also like to take a moment to acknowledge once more today's jury. Dr. Douglas Humphreys, the chair of the piano department at the Eastman School of Music and the artistic director of the Gina Backauer International Piano Foundation, is the jury chair. Morihiko Nakahara, music director of the South Carolina Philharmonic, is also a jury member, as is Marina Lamazov, founder and artistic director of the Southeastern Piano Festival. We would like to thank the dean of the University of South Carolina School of Music, Taylor Harding, for all of his support of this event over many years, and particularly so during the unusual year in which we find ourselves. His support has been invaluable in getting the right facilities, the right protocols, and the right series of events to make this possible. So thank you to Dean Taylor Harding. We'd also like to thank the many donors and supporters that make the festival possible year in and year out. Each one of you has made differences in a great number of young people's music instruction in careers. We are very grateful to each of you and certainly look forward to the day when we can see all of you in person. I'd like to thank once again Jeff Francis, our recording engineer and chief technology consultant and director for this event today, Paul Williams, our wonderful piano technician who spent a lot of time working on these two Steinways in advance of the competition. I'd also like to thank our associate director, John Holloway, our assistant directors, Hyun Jung Im and Lisa Churchia, and all of the staff of the Southeastern Piano Festival. We are very grateful to you, and we certainly couldn't do it without you. I'd like to thank also Inara Zanmana, our wonderful second pianist, for working with us for so many years. Thank you, Inara. And now we'll begin the ventilation period and look forward to resuming the competition in a few minutes. In the meantime, we've provided some programming for you during this period if you'd like to continue listening, and we certainly hope you do. See you in a few minutes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon. It's time to resume the Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition with contestant number 4, Benjamin Hoang. He will be playing Rachmaninoff's Third Concerto in D minor in the third movement of Beethoven Appassionata Sonata.
Following the score and doing what the composer wants is important. So what I try to do when I play music and what I do best is to express myself through the music and to have fun with it. So I feel like expressing yourself and having fun while following like what the composer wants is important.
Thank you. Our fifth and final contestant this afternoon is Lucas Amory, and he's playing Beethoven Piano Concerto No. 3 in C minor and Liszt Reminiscences of Norma.
Was just listening to that and just feeling an overpowering sense of glee and just like happiness. And that's just like getting those experiences. That's why I'm part of music. That's why I really enjoy it. And that's why I want to continue on doing it.
Good evening. We've just concluded our final performance of the 2020 Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition. I would like to thank our jurors, Dr. Douglas Humphreys, Chair of the Piano Department at the Eastman School of Music and Artistic Director of the Gina Backhauer International Piano Foundation, and also Chair of the Jury of the Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition. Morihiko Nakahara, Music Director of the South Carolina Philharmonic Orchestra, Resident Conductor of the Spokane Symphony Orchestra, and Professor of Conducting at the University of Massachusetts Amherst, and Marina Lamazov, Founder and Artistic Director of the Southeastern Piano Festival. We will now break for a jury deliberation, and we will reconvene at about 6 o'clock for the announcement of the results. We hope to see you then.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us for the awards presentation of the 2020 Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition. It's really been a wonderful day filled with piano music by five very gifted artists, and it was really a privilege for us to host them here at the University of South Carolina. I would like to recognize our jury, Dr. Douglas Humphreys, chair of the jury and chair of the piano department at the Eastman School of Music. Dr. Humphreys is also artistic director of the Gina Backhauer International Piano Foundation. Morihiko Nakahara, music director of the South Carolina Philharmonic Orchestra, resident conductor of the Spokane Symphony, and professor of conducting at the University of Massachusetts Amherst. And Marina Lamazov, founder and artistic director of the Southeastern Piano Festival and professor of piano at the Eastman School of Music. Thanks to each of you. We'd also like to thank everyone that made this event possible. Jeff Francis, our chief recording engineer and director of technology. Paul Williams, our piano technician. Inara Zanmana, our wonderful orchestral pianist. And all of our staff, from assistant directors to our photographer, Mike Bull. It takes a number of people to make an event like this happen, and we are very, very grateful and honored to be associated with each of you. We would like to thank the Symphony League of the South Carolina Philharmonic for sponsoring this event. We would like to thank Rice Music House and Steinway & Sons for being the official piano of the Southeastern Piano Festival. And now I will turn the microphone over to Dr. Lamazov for the announcement of the results.
This is the moment we've all been waiting for. We have heard some absolutely outstanding playing today. We enjoyed every minute of it, especially knowing what it takes during these uncertain times to come and play live and unfortunately not have an audience in a hall to cheer you, but to know that thousands of you are watching out there and cheering on for these outstanding young performers. I would like to acknowledge the work of the young performers, their teachers, their parents, and their network of support that goes into every single performance you hear. It's hours and hours of work, and it's years and years of training. And we're so grateful to all of you out there for continuing to support art, music, and youth as they strive to be the best they can.
We would also like to acknowledge the young jury. The Southeastern Piano Festival has a special prize that's awarded by a jury of piano performance students at the University of South Carolina and at universities around the country. This year's young jury was chaired by Matthew Figgle, a piano student at the Eastman School of Music. Other young jury members were Andrew Choi, a doctoral student at the University of South Carolina, and Yanting Wang, also a doctoral student at the University of South Carolina. Thanks to each of you.
The young jury has emailed us their nomination for their award, but they chose to be in suspense to hear how the awards were distributed. So they're waiting, as well as you are, to hear the nomination of the awards. And now we will start with the award ceremony. We will start first with the prize for the best solo work. And that award goes to Lucas Amory.
Congratulations.
Next, we will announce the two discretionary awards in no particular order. They go to Ben, Hoang. Congratulations, Ben. The other discretionary award goes to Katie Liu. Congratulations, Katie. Next, we will announce the Young Jury Award. The Young Jury Award goes to Lucas Amory. Lucas, you're already on stage. Congratulations. Tseng. Congratulations, Karina. Congratulations. Marvelous. The second prize was awarded to Lucas Amory. Bravo. Congratulations, Lucas. And now, it's our pleasure to announce that by unanimous jury vote, the first prize was delivered to Caleb Borick. Congratulations, Caleb. Congratulations. Bravo. Congratulations. We present to you the 2020 Southeastern Piano Festival Arthur Fraser International Piano Competition finalists. Bravo to all of you. We are so proud of you, your work. You were outstanding today. Thank you for being here.
We would like to thank once more everyone who made this event possible during such unusual times. And above all, we would like to thank these fabulous young artists that went through a three-round process to get to this point and who traveled to Columbia, South Carolina and played so brilliantly today. Congratulations to each of you. We wish you all the best. Thank you to everyone who listened on the live stream, both during the competition and during this ceremony. Please be safe, please be well, and we wish all of you a wonderful evening. Thank you.
We have